So, lovely people at World of Snacks sent me this. It's a box with foreign stuff in it.
Lots of foreign stuff.
If there's one thing that excites me more than buying a couple steaks and making beef jerky out of it, that is foreign candies and foreign snacks. Because we all know I'm the one in the house that brings in all the weirdly branded ramen noodles, oddly branded chips. So this is sort of
we have like Philippines, China, Japan.
Philippines, Japan,
Mexico,
Germany, Thailand, and I think that's it.
Deutschland.
I'll know when I see it. Well, I think one of them's from mainland China. So, I think we're going to start with, the melon gum. It's by...
It's gum.
Yeah, so this is from Japan.
Is that like one piece? Is that like four?
It's called Marukawa Melon Bubblegum. Artificially flavored, of course, just like all your favorites.
Okay.
So, we'll just...
Let's check it.
Yeah. Quite green and colorful, yes.
Yeah, I'm excited for this one because... Oh, they're not... It's not...
My stupid PC timing out and all that.
So what do they look like in there?
So, in here, they're just white balls.
They're just white balls?
They're just white balls. So you grab a white ball.
Okay. Now, I'm excited about this because this... I love melon.
Oh, God, wait.
No one knows how much I love melon.
I'll grab a white ball too. Yeah, 3, 2, 1.
Oh, soft.
We're just not gonna talk about what I just lifted. I just lifted an air biscuit.
Now that is so good.
That tastes like a honeydew melon. It tastes like a fresh honeydew melon. Seriously.
It's so soft, and I feel like I could swallow, but yeah. I'm not going to.
Like, you want to, because it's like, it's so...
It's so soft. It's mushy. It's
nice and pliable. You don't have to, like, crunch into it like a double bubble
ball
or anything. It crunches down really easily. It's real nice.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What's your rating, then? What's mine? I mean, we could do it out of 10.
We could add them. Mm-hmm. Okay, 1 to 10?
No, 1 to 10.
8.
8? Yeah, I would say a 9. 17 out of 20. I guess it'll give us...
17 for the additional... For, like, us, right?
I guess that'll give us a better, like, accuracy, I guess.
Yeah, mm-hmm. If we had 3 people, we'd have the 3 people.
Mm-hmm.
The way that came out, though.
You walk, and then one for moi.
Now, I don't know what these are, but...
So, these things are organic red ginseng. Candies. They're like
ginseng
jellies.
Chicken.
Yeah, organic red ginseng jellies. Organic red ginseng jellies. Wait. Think of it like...
So this is what the package looks like.
It's really cool.
It's black and it has Korean... Is that Korean?
This is from South Korea. These are the ones. Yeah.
Korean writing.
These are from South Korea. All right. So let's check it out. It does not look red at all to me.
It does not smell good.
It doesn't have a smell.
Smell it.
Oh, it smells...
It smells like earthy.
Oh, it smells grassy, yeah.
Okay, what it's is sticky. This? I'm going to bite it from the wrapper.
Look at that.
It smells like... Okay, what does it smell like to you? It
smells like aloe. It smells like a fresh aloe leaf.
It smells like aloe.
That's
like
weird.
Like the aloe gel.
That is weird.
Okay, I'm not excited for this, but let's... 3, 2, 1.
Let's sink it. What is this?
Oh, no.
Taste it. terrible.
That was a.
If you don't, just toss it, man.
I do not like it. Oh! So 1 to 10?
It's a 1 for me.
It's a 1, so it's a 2 for both of us.
Ooh, 2 out of 20. That's nothing.
I'm not going to give it a 0, because that we have not reached the grossest thing yet. So what else
do I think that is the grossest thing. Right after this, we're recording the episode of LSD.
At 12, so soon.
Milk candy. Japan.
White Rabbit.
White Rabbit brand milk candies. From Japan. So these... Specifically from Sapporo. So, what you're going to find when you...
This looks harmless.
Oh, I think it is harmless, because milk candies are usually a crowd favorite in Japan. Doesn't matter if they're flavored or not.
Oh, it's like a...
So, there's rice paper on the outside of it. So, it looks like it's another wrapper, but that actually melts in your mouth. It's completely edible paper. It's made of rice.
I was actually just thinking, just put it in, but it's just rolled... a rice wrapper, and I just started taking it off.
You take this wrapper off, and there's another wrapper on the outside of it that looks
Starburst.
Looks like paper. But that's Starburst. Yeah, that's rice gluten.
In America.
Yeah.
Right? Okay, don't they have, like, the, like, weird skin on the outside of Starburst in America?
No, they don't. They don't put rice paper on the outside of gummies in America.
Well, because...
Because if they did, people would be like, what? This, they do this because it's... I don't know why they do it. But okay, 3, 2, 1, sink it. That will melt. You put the whole thing in. Whole thing in. Let it melt. Let it go. Keep working on it. Just, like, mash it.
My mouth wants to... It does not taste good.
Right now. I like it. Tastes creamy. Tastes like... Come on.
Right now I'm hating it, but...
It tastes like a sweet custard.
I want to like it.
Keep
it's
working on
rice
it.
It's not rice paper. It's the texture.
Mm. Keep working on it.
Now, I don't like a lot of, like, creamy things like custard. That's why I don't like this. I'm like in the middle. It's so in the middle.
This gets a 10 out of 10 for me.
I'm gonna go 4.
This is perfect. I love it. Mm-hmm.
14. You know what? I'll give it a 6. 16.
16 out of 20.
You know, I'm just kind of like this more that the rice paper's gone.
It's nice, it's smooth, and it tastes like a sweet custard. Mm-hmm.
Perfect.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. So they also, whenever you get a box from them, they give you a nice little sticker here. WOS. World of Snacks.
Yep.
It's a sticker, and you can plunk it anywhere. You can put it on your left butt cheek if you want. All right.
You can put on your left nut if you want.
Ew. You, like, try to take it off, it rips all the hairs out. Wait.
No.
This is called Stroopwafel.
This is a waffle.
It's a waffle with
artificial syrup in it.
It's a waffle filled with caramel, cinnamon, and bourbon vanilla. This hail's from Germany. All right, so when you open it, the first thing that's going to catch your eye is waffle.
Is this.
That smells nice.
It smells like a trip to Bennett's.
A trip to Bennett's? Oh, yeah.
Like, where you smell those, like, pies and, like, the cinnamon.
There's only one Bennett's location.
Now look at this.
And we've got it.
So come to us. Come to us. Come to Hamilton, Ontario.
It's like a flat waffle thing. With, like, caramel in it and, like, I guess in it there's, like, a vanilla filling.
Now, I'm a huge fan of, like, maple syrup.
Smell it. That smells good.
It smells like something I want to eat.
Yeah, it looks like a toasted waffle.
It's the best waffle I've ever seen.
Ready to sink it? Let's go for it.
Okay.
It tastes like...
It's waffly. creamy.
I get the bourbon vanilla, I get the cinnamon, and I get the caramel.
This is really, really good.
Mm-hmm.
But something missing.
What's missing? Like
this
a big.
There's not a lot of flavor.
Just a big stein full of like stout or something.
this is really good. Like I do recommend it, but
100%.
It's just like a.
Well, no one
else. Missing something.
Okay. This gets my 9 out of 10.
Just get, 8.
17. Another solid 17.
Another 17.
We have a runner-up to the melon gum.
Okay, let's put this aside, because we need to move on.
Yeah, we're gonna definitely work on these a bit later. Just stack yours on top
of
mine.
Mine's on top.
Now.
Yeah. I'll put this the other way.
Yep.
Alright.
Botan rice candy.
Botan. Botan.
Think about... Or it could be Botan, because botanicals. Because this is flavored with a flower. I don't know what flower. I didn't research that much into it. Blah, blah, blah. Sweet rice, lemon flavor, orange flavor. Never mind. I guess it's not flavored with a flower. Unwrap it. It unwraps just like a package of, like, gum. Where it's got, like, the one little plastic thing that, like, you pick it up and it goes...
What I'm picking up from this is, like, something you would see in, like, the store level in the Beautiful Katamari.
Wait. Before we move on to this, I have a slight little message to Danny.
It made me feel so terrible sometimes.
Oh. There's like 6 candies in there, and it comes with, it says free children's sticker inside. There's a sticker.
Free children's sticker inside.
That doesn't affect us.
Oh. Really, 5.
We're just here for the candy. Here's yours. Botan rice candy. It's a lemon and orange flavor. I thought it was... It says Botan, so I think, oh, it's flower flavoring in there. No. Just lemon and orange. Maybe it's lemon and orange blossom.
Oh, there's rice.
Yeah, this... Okay. See that? That's totally okay. That goes
all
in your
this.
Mouth and... It, all of that. That's rice paper, dude. That melts in your mouth.
Let's just see how it smells first.
It smells like nothing, because it's wrapped in rice paper.
Okay. Well, let's just,
sink it.
Oh.
Leave it. Let it melt. It'll taste like flour.
I hate the rice paper, man.
You know why they do that? It's just so that way the
it
candy...
It makes me want to...
You know why they do that? It's so that way the candy doesn't stick to the wrapper.
Oh, man. Now I'm biting into it.
Mm-hmm. Lemon and orange just punches you in the mouth. But it's not sour. It's sweet.
It's a cleaner.
And it's like really... smooth, really good texture.
Oh my. I think I just got like a wave of just like. You know what I mean?
Japan's doing their candy right.
It's so strong. It tastes like pine salt.
It even says right here, wait. Each candy has an edible inner wrapper that melts in your mouth. It's to tell retarded foreigners like us, hey, don't throw up because it's just rice paper.
You know what?
I like this better than Starburst.
It's not too bad.
Starburst would get like a 7 out of 10 for me because there's so many flavors that I can't stand.
It gets better as a chip.
This one, it's one flavor, so you know what you're getting. And it's like, it's not necessarily a gummy, it's a chewy. It's perfect. I love it.
Okay, so score. Yep.
So this gets my 9 out of 10. Because it's not perfect.
6. That's a 15.
It's a fuff.
That's
a
15.
It's a fuff out of 10.
Foy.
15 out of 20.
Foy. Yeah.
Botan rice candy. Oh, in Japan. You know what you're doing with your candies, guys. Next one.
Wow.
Lucas salsa getty from Mexico.
Okay.
I think it's watermelon flavor. Yeah.
Yeah, I like like melon.
There's a lot of ingredients in there. Oh.
Yeah, from now on you know that I like my melon.
There's sauce? It comes with sauce.
Like what kind of watermelon sauce?
I have no idea. I'm actually scared.
Let's just go into this because we want to know.
Oh, smell that.
Ugh.
It's like they took candy and just put, like, chili powder on it.
Dude, and this is the sauce. It's just like, this is the sauce.
You didn't see that, but when Danny grabbed that, like, this thing just went like...
we'll need to split that. You know what, you'll grab... Okay, you know...
It's like they took chili flakes and put it on the outside of the candy.
Okay.
What?
So what are we doing with this?
Okay, so we're going to put this on the back burner here. What we first need to do is each grab a noodle here.
Okay, you're just... How about you just take a bite? Or,
we need to each grab a noodle. We need to each grab the noodle. You grab a noodle. I'll hold the concoction down while you try and get your noodle there.
It's so sticky.
Okay. Make sure it goes back in the tray. What? Small noodle! Okay, whatever.
This is taste test.
Fine. All right.
Three.
Two. One.
Oh. Mmm. Oh, yeah. That's so good.
That's bizarre.
No.
It tastes like...
Ugh. It's spicy.
There is chili flakes on the outside. I couldn't read the ingredients, because they're all in a... I can't.
I thought it was good.
That's the...
It's good, but... It's spicy.
That's the idea. It's good.
Okay, score.
The flavor... No, we haven't. This is on the back burner, because we have to try it with the sauce. With the sauce. It's also...
I'm really hating the chili flakes.
It's also immensely sticky on the outside. And I figured that would take away from the salsa Getty experience here.
All right. So, what was that sound?
So
I guess we just rip it open and dip.
Grab a full noodle. I'll grab you a full noodle because I don't want you dinking out on it again. There's your noodle. Your noodle.
We have to eat two of these.
We each are going to have a noodle.
Dude, there's like a flake.
I'm trying to figure out, like.
Oh, it tastes foul.
It's called Lucas Gusano. It is flavored hot liquid candy.
Hot
liquid candy.
Is it really hot? No.
Well, if those were spicy to you, this one will be.
Oh, I'm talking about the temperature.
Well, you obviously don't want to heat up candy. Ew, it looks like Taco Bell sauce.
Okay, I'm not gonna go full noodle. I'm gonna...
Here's our tray, and you can see, like, down there, there's, like, the sauce.
People enjoy this?
Yeah, kids in Mexico, I guess, enjoy this. All right, so dink it in the sauce.
Well...
Make sure you get a good saturation on there.
Okay.
All right.
For Mexicans.
For Mexico.
For Mexico.
Por uno Mexicana. Okay. Three, two, one.
Lucia. No, can't do it.
That's... Did you just like you yacked on my floor?
No.
I honestly, it tastes like Taco Bell sauce.
No.
Just plunk that in there.
Okay, so we're gonna give two. So one with the sauce and one without.
One with the sauce. We each add up our score there. And then divide it by two. So, mine. Without the sauce, it gets like a 3. With the sauce, gets a 2. So, it's a 2.5 from me. So, without the sauce, what do you think?
It's like a... It's a 1.
It's a 1 with the sauce? 0?
It would, like, minus 1.
So, it's so a 1.5 out of 20. So, it was almost...
That was not good. I'm waiting for some... I'm waiting for something to happen here.
It was almost as bad as the ginseng jellies. Since you're on a strain of like things that taste terrible, let's go with this. So this rains from the Philippines. It's called Boy Bawang Cornic. I like to call it Boy Bawang because I've had one flavor of this before. I think it was just like.
I feel like we need to boil our mouths after this.
Yeah, like, we don't even have a palate cleanser. It doesn't matter. It's just, we're just tasting confection.
We're just mixing.
We're just tasting snacks. I mean...
Good and bad.
If you've got the snackies, you'd probably just do this anyway. You wouldn't really want to wash it down with anything.
Yeah. I'm daydreaming right now. Night dreaming.
Boy Bawang Cornic. But I don't like the Cornic part. I just like Boy Bawang.
Boy it's Bawang, like, it's...
Boy Bawang. Boy Bawang.
Okay, so...
So we were at a birthday party, and someone had these on the table, and I just, like, jacked the whole bag. Like, I just took it. And I think it was just, I think it was, like, the zesty flavor. It was, like, spicy. It was just, like, a chili flavor. These are chili cheese. So I figured these will actually be better than the ones I had at that birthday party.
I'm, like, falling.
This kid's been falling off the chair the whole day.
Got a pair of scissors.
Because this is a tough bag.
Let's just go in.
We'll grab a tiny handful, like, that many. We'll give you guys a little tour of inside the bag there. They're just like fried corns with cheese on them.
Okay.
3, 2, 1.
No. Not as bad as I thought. They're pretty good. Just the smell. Smells bad. Taste? Good.
Grab some more now. You're not getting the full flavor. You have to have a few and just keep chaining them.
That's good.
These are great, man. Out of this whole thing, I think these are my favorite.
I think.
10 out of 10.
We know the answer to this one.
Mm-hmm.
10. 20.
20. This is like the
top.
This
is the one. I knew this was going to be the one.
These
that
are
got
so
10.
Good, man.
I know this is the one.
Mm-hmm.
I knew.
I'm loving this so far.
We gotta move on.
That was good.
Now all right. This.
So this might be a little change of pace. It's salmon skin that's just been fried. And it's like a chip or something.
You know when you don't want something to end? There's one more thing to end.
Yeah. Maybe there's like a mystery thing that I forgot that I ordered. I have a feeling that's not the case.
Okay, right. We have one more thing.
Let's get the salmon skin open. So what we're first going to have to do is...
Stretch. Because...
I'm just going to get that away from you because I know what this is going to be like already. Get ready for the palate cleanser. Yours is on top, right?
Okay. You know, I'm just going to go in for a tiny bite, and I'm just going to... This is a taste test. We're not devouring these. So...
Just get a little bit of your palate cleanser there. You're going to need it. You're done.
Now.
Okay.
He isn't hyping me up for any of this.
The first thing that we have to do is smell. But what I'm going to do is give the camera a look of it. Because I know what this looks like.
What?
Have a look. These are salmon skins. Smell.
It smells like
fish
food. Trip to the aquarium.
It smells like fish food that you put in like a fish tank.
Trip to the aquarium.
Okay, just grab one of the smaller ones down at the back there.
Yeah, I'm just gonna grab this.
This might be better. This might be better than we think.
No,
so don't think the worst. This might be better than we think it is. I'm excited to try this because I've never tried anything like this in my life. All right.
I'm going to keep an open... Let's keep an open mind. Let's just...
Okay, think about it. We've both tried pork rinds, right? Those are terrible.
Yeah, it's just skin off of an edible fish. These are cooked.
These are like... These are fish... Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, they're fried, dude. These are fish... Fried. This is fish rinds. So it'll be way better than pork rinds.
Yes, I like salmon, but I've never... Mm-hmm. Eaten skin in chip form,
but it's totally edible. Like it's like a snack.
But it smells like cat food.
Here, I think of most places on earth, there's pork rinds and it's fried pork skin, and I hate it. It's gross. It's like dry, like bacony flavor.
Now 1 to 10, how excited are you?
How excited am I?
I'm 3.
And my excitement's starting to die down. I'd say about 5. I'm like, But it might be interesting, so...
Okay, let me smell my finger after touching it. Okay, that does not... Okay, let's just...
Cheers. 3, 2, 1.
Okay. disappointing. Oh no!
He's just like yakking in that box there.
No, come here.
Oh, it's like it's got like this sweetness to it.
You're liking this?
Why is there like a sweetness on it?
You're liking this?
It's actually, it's like, it's okay, dude. Because okay, you would be reacting a lot worse to pork rinds. Tell you that much.
Okay,
way better than pork rinds.
I don't like rinds.
But pork rinds would get a zero from me anyway.
Because of my reaction and all this is that, and I had to like.
I'm really not.
I almost threw up.
That was just really punch you in the face type of.
That's like -3 for me. You can go in the minus up to -10.
Might as well, but I'm giving these. Please. I'm giving them a 1.
Okay, just.
Because they're bearable, but I wouldn't choose to eat these. Think realistically.
-3 plus, so that's
-2. What are you doing? What are you doing with that? We have a new palate cleanser.
All right.
We have Boy Bolang.
Boy
Cornet.
Okay. Mm. I'm starting to get sick of those, so let's have a taste.
These taste better after dealing with that. Chocolate shake flavored candies. EXO, Jack and Jill. I think these are from, let's see, Philippines.
I still have the salmon in, like, the back of my throat.
Yeah,
here.
Need more palate cleanser?
No, we're about to try something else, and I'm excited for it.
Yeah, these are from the Philippines, called EXO Classics.
We deal with salty, we deal with sweet, now we're...
Chocolate shake candies.
Now we're going on to,
They're hard candies.
Hard candies.
They're hard candies, yeah. So they're sort of like, here we have Werther's Original. They're in the U.S. and...
But we have never...
Yeah.
We have never came across a chocolate flavor. I'll just grab one.
You get just like a whole mess of them inside there. These
cool.
Look awesome, man.
They come in like individual wrappers and all that, so...
Mm-hmm. Individual little wrappers. Say EXO right there.
They look pretty fancy. Like, this is what the rich people eat. This is what the rich people eat.
Looks like a little chocolate, but looks can be deceiving because
it's a hard candy.
Dead solid. It's hard candy.
It's like a rock, but
hey, that means that the flavor lasts in your face.
Well,
cheers, mon. 3, 2, 1, sink it.
Oh, it's tasting like the milk thing, but better.
Simply good. Tastes like a chocolate ice cream milkshake. With a little bit of synthetic flavor in there.
It tastes like the milk thing. You know what? 10 out of 10, easily.
These get your 10? These get my 8, I would say. But
18.
Your tastes are different from me.
18, mm-hmm. I am.
We have, the Boy Bolangs are the only thing that got perfect. So...
We know our new, okay, we can, the sad thing is that once we run out of these, we can't get, except for that, and everything else that was disgusting, we can't get these good foods unless we order them, so.
But you can get them, because the fine peoples here sent these. It's, you just go on their website.
Not sponsored.
Not sponsored, yeah.
Obviously.
You just get it from the site, and you get Boy Bolang and disgusting sauce spaghetti and salmon skin and like.
Well, you
crap,
can
man.
Pick what you want, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
What you want, not what I want. But definitely,
anyone can pick whatever they want.
If you're looking for something good,
something,
definitely
some EXO,
some EXO,
some Boy Bolang, some. Stoop waffles, or some Botan rice candy, or got everything in there. Yep. So that was our world of snacks. Yet again, not sponsored. Random box mix taste test and new videos daily.